my mother commenting about my weight, especially after my father passed away when I was 6. I was put on diets, one after the other, too many to keep track of. I looked at magazines and thought, if only I were skinny like that model. I dressed in baggy clothes. My mother told me that they made me look fat. I would snack on last night's leftovers and get yelled at because my mom had planned that for dinner. I constantly heard, you're eating us out of house and home.
When I was in third grade, I told my mother I needed glasses because I had trouble seeing the blackboard. She said I was trying to be like the other girls who wore glasses. I had to wait 3 years to finally get glasses. Once when dancing with my friend Davida in the fifth grade, all my mother could say was, oh, those hips. I hid sanitary napkins in my closet when I started my period. I was 12, and it had been ingrained in me that I wasn't okay. In high school, I was in a modern dance performance. My mother told me I didn't stand up straight entering the stage. Was it any wonder? My mother was always perfectly coiffed. When I begged her to let me get my hair done for my senior yearbook picture, she simply said, no. My mother's comments and actions said that I wasn't important, and that it's always better to criticize than to say nothing. I want to tell that voice that holds me back, the voice that keeps me enslaved to my fears, insecurities, self-pity, and self-condemnation, to get the hell away from me.
I got married at the age of 19. We eloped after he told me that this would be my last chance. We got married one night after I finished work at the AMP. I didn't feel very pretty, but I wanted the night to be special. I knew he liked blue, so I purchased a powder blue two-piece negligee. I prepared myself and floated into the room as if royalty were arriving. I felt gorgeous, and I felt sexy. He looked at me and said, what the hell is this all about? I told him I wanted to look pretty for him. He said I shouldn't have wasted my money. All he wanted was the negligee off. My bubble burst. My joy deflated. I felt self-conscious and unattractive. I kept the negligee for a while, as beautiful as it was, but I never wore it again.
I grew up with mixed messages about what sexy and pretty are. I was never sure if it was a good thing or a bad thing. Sexy and pretty meant being dumb and trampy. Choice altering, life limiting. If I think I look sexy, I worry that I may be trashy or provocative. If I think I look pretty, I wonder how to maintain the look, when to reapply makeup, how to keep my hair in place, how to keep my slip from showing. I feel my best when I'm working physically, maybe because I'm preoccupied and not thinking about how I look. Maybe the dirt and sweat cover the blemishes. Then I feel my best when I'm finished with hard work and have relaxed muscles and freshly washed skin. No one knew back then how tremendously
The words you heard as a child would forever impact your life. Those words from childhood can make you a self-loathing adult.
I feel physically satisfied on a warm summer day with a little sun and wearing something loose and flowing. But it may have nothing to do with pretty or sexy.
Beauty comes from one's spirit, one's heart. I've seen gorgeous women whose beauty is overshadowed by unattractive behavior. They did not act beautiful.
I want to know that I'm beautiful inside and out, no matter what.